Well, the moment has passed. Back to work.
Hey, everybody. It's the Master Shpee here, and I'm here to tell you all the good big brain thinkings that you are gonna need to become a master spy yourself. Because I've seen a lot of videos on the internet that are telling you to do this, that, and the other thing, and they're all wrong, okay? You take all those videos and you just throw them out, okay? You physically rip them off your screen, throw them in the trash. They're useless, okay? I'm going to tell you the big brain things that you need to do in order to get your knife into the back of your enemies, so you can then subsequently apologize to them for killing them. First of all, here's what I want you to do. My mum told me this, so you know what's right. Keep your friends close, but keep your enemies closer. At the start of the round, you want to be right at the spawn door. You want to get that first kill, get it up on the board, put that fear of the spy into them. See, I saw my fellow spy there. He was right up there at the spawn, and he knew what was up. You've got to do it. You've got to put in their mind that you are a thing to fear. They've got to be scared. And look at these guys. They weren't near our spawn. Get away. You two. Oh, I couldn't kill him. Maybe my friends will get him. I've got to go and get closer to the enemy, just like my mum said. Oh, the next thing is, just like my mum said, you got to start the day with a good breakfast. So I don't know what you had for breakfast. It's probably something Americanized. You've got to get that out of your system. If you want to be a true spy, you've got to start the day off with a croissant and some wine. In fact, I want you to change up your whole dietary regime. I want you to work in some other things like some omelets and some crepes and, I don't know, maybe some baguette. Work in some ratatouille and some quiche. I mean, real men eat quiche. I don't know who told you that real men do not eat quiche. Real men eat quiche, all right? Just trust me, it's big-brained, it's gonna work. Next, you gotta consider what you're wearing. I mean, you've gotta dress for the job that you want, not the job you have. And if you wanna be a master spy, you're gonna have to suit the part. And in order to suit the part, you're gonna need a suit. If you don't have a suit in your closet, what are you? You're just one of these scouts or something. Probably wearing a baseball cap. And if you don't have all that, at least put on the gibbous and pyrovision goggles. You gotta at least do that. Next, we've gotta talk about your facial hair situation. I mean, if you're not sporting a proper mustache or a goatee or something like that, what are you? You're not a spy. And I'm talking to you too, ladies. You need to grow yourself a mustache if you wanna play spy. If you wanna be a master spy, it's gotta be done. The sacrifices have to be made. Because fine facial hair says that you care about your kills. And if you don't care about your kills, you might as well be a clean-shaven, crew-cutted soldier. Ugh, the very thought of it, how disgusting. Now they tell me you should also have a plan, you know, have a plan before you go into battle. Go in with a battle plan. That is nonsense. A plan lasts only as soon as the timer starts. After that, it all goes to heck. People get shot, somebody dies, somebody screams for their mama, and it is all over. Don't have a plan. Plans are for losers. I want you to adapt to any situation. I want you to be ready. Scouts seeing you, get away. Pyros burning you, get away. Snipers sniping your head, you're probably dead, but still try and get away. And you know what happens if you keep getting away? You will get away with murder. Yes, that's right, ladies and gentlemen. You'll get away with murder. You'll be able to murderize all of them. They'll be falling over right in front of your eyes. Look at this guy. He's probably sniping at something important. Wrong. He's dead. Look at this guy. He's looking for me. He's not going to find me. He's not going to find me at all. I'm going to take this away. Let's look at what's going on. That demo man's looking for me. He ain't going to find me. That soldier's looking for me. He ain't gonna find me. Because you know why? I'm sitting right here and I'm going, don't see me, don't see me, don't see me, don't see me, don't see me. You say don't see me enough and it will psychically go to them and they will subsequently not see you. Like, look at this. Don't see me, don't see me, don't see me, don't see me. He didn't see me. He didn't see nothing. No reaction whatsoever. Suddenly, next thing you know, it's murder time. Oh, you have to develop a laugh. If you don't have a murder laugh already, you have to develop a murder laugh. Some sort of evil cackling laugh. Some deep-bellied laugh where you can stab someone in the back and go, mwahaha! Next thing I want you to do is hold your knife backwards, because that's how you get face stabs. Simply flip the knife around in your hand and stab backwards instead of forwards. Here's another piece of advice that I saw from a master spy. I think it was in this little movie called The Spider-Verse. You should disinfect your mask and use baby powder. Definitely use baby powder. The heavies will smell that. They'll think that it's just one of the babies on their team. While we're on the subject of babies, you should act weak and feeble as much as possible. It lulls people into a false sense of security, so even the medics will think you're one of their own weak and feeble baby teammates. Giving you the Uber. Thank you very much. Be sure and say thank you before you try and shoot them up. But if you want to have a really big brain like me, you've got to pay attention to everything. Look at that. Did you see that? The engineer didn't see that. Only I saw that. I saw what that demo man was doing. I know where he's going. He's going to go spawn camping. What a lowlife. What kind of lowlife comes and attacks your spawn and takes out your teleporters? Not today, son. Go back to demo man school, because I am so observant and I watch everything. And what's going on behind me? Oh, heck, there's another one. I didn't see that. Well, I better take care of that, because nobody else is going to take care of that. I am the master spy. Nothing gets past me. Nothing and no one gets past me, because I observe everything. I'm looking at the kill feed. I'm looking at my ammo count. I'm looking at a cloak meter. I'm looking at my life meter. I'm looking at my disguise. I'm looking at what my disguise is wearing. I'm looking at it all. And I have to pay attention to everything. What was that? Oh, bloody another one. Come here. Stop it already. I'm trying to do big brain plays here. And you know what else I say? If you want something done right, do it yourself. And that is just wrong on all levels. If you want something done, have somebody else do it. There you go. Pay them to do it. Good job. You sapped it. There you go. You throw yourself in front of that pyro. I'm going to get away. Just have some other schmuck do it for you. Why risk your own life when you can risk somebody else's life? That's what I always say. I've heard them say out there that if you're a good player, all you got to do is to keep playing the way you're playing, and eventually you'll get a good team out there. But that's a bunch of hooey. Because the perfect team would be you playing with 12 more versions of yourself, cloned in your likeness and trained in your ways. And that ain't ever going to happen. They say you should play hard to get. I think they're talking about relationships, but it applies to spying. You should be hard to get. They should be committing their entire team to try and find out where you are and counter what you are doing. If a plan doesn't go to plan, you should plan that that plan wasn't going to go to plan and have another plan for that. Failing to plan is planning to fail. Well, what if you don't plan straight at all? Just frickin' wing it. Then once it all works out, you can do one of your maniacal laughs. And they'll laugh along with you because, you know, it's funny. Because listen, if your team can't handle you at your worst, then they don't deserve you at your best. You ever heard that? It's true. Next piece of advice for the big brain spies: how to remove bloodstains from clothes. It's gonna happen. You're gonna get blood everywhere. First, you want to gently dab the area with some cold water. You don't want to spread the blood around. That's going to make it too messy and too hard to clean. But you got to remove as much blood as possible as quickly as possible, so dab that away. Next thing, I want you to go to the medicine cabinet. Get some hydrogen peroxide. If you don't have hydrogen peroxide, then, I don't know, become an adult or something. Get some hydrogen peroxide. You're going to need it. Apply a little hydrogen peroxide and you'll watch that blood stain just disappear. Now, if it's an older stain and it's something that's got away on you, you do have to be careful, because hydrogen peroxide is a real, real mild bleach, okay? So, of course you're wearing fine clothes. We already covered that. You should be wearing your fine clothes, right? So, try the hydrogen peroxide on some hidden part of the garment. Something that you're not going to see, and if it fails or it bleaches out your color, you're not going to ruin your clothes. You don't want to ruin a suit over some git that got killed. So next, when you're a big brain spy like me, you often get told, hey, you're just lucky all the time. How do you get so lucky? Why are you lucky? I'll tell you the secret, right? The secret is to have a lucky horseshoe. Go out, find yourself an honest-to-goodness, heavy iron wrought horseshoe. Carry it with you. And then when you see an enemy, hit them over the head with a horseshoe. Once they're stunned, you can stab them in the back. You'll have a much luckier time killing some idiot that's been hit over the head with a horseshoe. Now, there are some animals associated with luck too, besides the horseshoe. You've heard of a lucky rabbit's foot. I can't confirm or deny the lucky rabbit's foot. I don't think it's very lucky for the rabbit myself. They say having a black cat crossing your path is unlucky, so I wouldn't advise having a black cat. But I tell you what animal is lucky. Ferrets. Own some ferrets. If you have some ferrets on your side, you'll be the luckiest spy that ever was. Because I can tell you just by looking at them, what spy owns a ferret and what spy doesn't own a ferret. Like, for example, this guy clearly doesn't own any ferrets. He probably owns a black cat or something. He should really change that out. But once you have a ferret on your side, you can do anything you want. You're bound to get lucky. It's just a matter of time. In fact, if you don't get lucky, let the ferret play. It'll probably play better than you anyway. Always use what Gaben give you. If Gaben gives you a pyro, use that pyro as bait. Simple as that. Gaben has blessed you, spies. Spies are his favorite class. He said it. It was out of his own mouth. Into my ear hole. You are lucky sons of guns. Blessed by the Gaben. Blessed by the... Okay, whatever. If you really want to get lucky, though, you're going to have to mask your decloaks. And the best way to mask your decloaks is to go on an all-chat server, and every time you decloak, just say something across the microphone. They won't be able to hear your decloak because, I don't know, you'll be jamming out a song or you'll be saying some nonsense words. Good spies are just lucky. That's all it is. It's luck all the time. No skill. I'd rather be lucky than skillful. Because lucky people always get the kills. Skillful people only sometimes get the kills when the skills happen. You want to be lucky. So the only way to be lucky is to believe that you are lucky. You are a Shpee. Pyros don't see you. Medics don't see you. Pocketed pyros don't see you. They are just going to die because you are a Shpee. It was bound to happen. It's destined to happen. You are that lucky spy they can never find that always kills them, and they've got them so paranoid they're spinning 180, shooting walls, shooting everywhere, just in the hopes of killing you. Well, that was lucky. What I'm really curious about is why Gaben, who loves spies after all, gave the pyro a jetpack. Jetpack's a very spy item, don't you think? Every spy movie I know of, the spy gets on some futuristic jetpack and flies to the enemy villain's place. I don't get it. Speaking of, if spy movies have taught me anything, is if the enemy catches you, try to get them talking about themselves. Get them monologuing and ask them some sort of question like, why is the cart not moving? And they'll be all like, oh bloody hell. And be sure to intentionally miss your shots. I mean, you don't need to kill them. You just need them to be afraid of being killed. Have them so afraid of being killed that they actually heal you to kill them. And if you don't kill them straight away, it only means you can kill them later. Don't ask me how this makes sense. It just does. You see them weak, and that's when you kill them. When it's the funniest. Remember our laugh? You need to practice those laughs. Because with your big brain thonking, your kills are going to come thick and fast, and you'll be invincible. Ah, crap. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. If you like this video, you'll probably like the other Shpee Thonks videos. They're a comical look at Spy in a way of making fun at myself. Be sure and smack that like, hit that subscribe, and put on notifications.